First bill on the agenda, 950 by Senator Marcellino.
An act to amend the real property tax law in relation to changes in assessment for businesses that make pilot payments.
Are there any no votes?
Move it.
Are there any votes without recommendation? Senator Warnock suggests we move the bill. 2733A by Senator Golden.
An act to amend the state finance law in relation to preferred source status for the purposes of procurement.
Are there any no votes?
Move it.
There is one no vote. Senator Parker, there are two no votes.
No, I don't have a question.
Okay, but Senator Parker, are you a no, sir?
I'm a no.
Senator Parker is a no. Senator Liz Krueger has a question.
Thank you. As I read the bill, it would give advantage to companies that have a presence here in New York State for contracting for procurement. But a presence could be a post office box. Is that a fair statement? It doesn't have to be that they're actually doing the reducing the goods that we would be procuring here in New York State.
It requires that the guidelines include the economic nexus. And so you are correct that technically a post office would suffice, but that would be evaluated as to the weight of the economic nexus that is present in the state.
I have one additional question, Mr. President.
Senator Krueger?
Mr. President. My reading of the bill is also it requires a company need not have more than one employee in the state of New York. Am I reading that correctly?
That is correct. It simply requires that the economic nexus to the state be considered as part of the totality of the circumstances.
Senator Perkins?
So let me ask a question. So how can this bill be abused?
How could it be abused?
Yeah, how can this law result in abuse? Possibility that this is subject to being abused. It seems to speak, has the right rhetoric to protect the New York Jobs Act, but the question is whether this has a mailbox and just and things like that might lead to some abuse.
We're gonna read you a paragraph that we believe answers your question,
right,
Senator.
We're gonna
read you a paragraph. Counsel, would you read this paragraph? Because I think this answers Senator Perkins' question.
Section 2 of the bill, as New York State-based businesses as preferred sources for the purpose of public contracts. To qualify, a business must have an organizational presence in New York State, generate at least 20% of its gross income from business conducted in the state, and have at least one employee located in the state, excluding employees whose primary role is government relations.
I guess, Senator Perkins, to answer your question, any type of legislation like this, you know, there's always the potential for abuse. I think that where the guidelines are pretty specific here. Yeah, Senator Hannon, go ahead.
Senator Perkins, this is additional requirements to get vendor contracts from the state. Currently, these do not exist. So any of these requirements are not met. It's adding 20% of the gross revenues. That's not necessarily the case now. The idea is to give a preference to people who are in the state, and these are the definitions of what's a presence in the state. But absent this statute, it can go to anybody, any place.
Thank you.
Senator Krueger? Senator Hasseltine.
I'm on my way.
She's yielding to you.
Talk.
Speak. Well, my concern about the question is that by giving preference, how does this affect our MWC procurement laws? And are they included or are
they remain the same? Those laws are not changed by the statutes. They remain the same. They still remain in place as they are right now. Senator Krueger, did you have a question?
Yes. Again, just putting together what Senator Cannon said and my colleague Senator Perkins said, it's true that right now we don't have any additional preference for New York. based companies when the state of New York does competitive bidding of products. My dilemma is my confusion that in going forward with a bill that is titled, actually the short paragraph, the short title, a Protect Your Jobs Act, I think it may be a misnomer title because yes, the company has to have a nexus here, which can't be a post office box, and yes, the company has to realize no less than 20% of its gross revenue here in the state of New York.
How's it going to be like
but in fact, it only needs to have one employee in the state of New York. So you could be a large multinational corporation whose products are produced, certainly not in New York State, and even conceivably not in the United States of America, as long as 20% of them are being sold in New York. And we're a big state, so it's not that hard to imagine a large multinational corporation selling 20% of fill-in-the-blank products in our state. And yet, this bill could still translate into our giving them an advantage competitively with other businesses in New York State when they got one person here. They happen to sell a lot of products to the citizens of the state, which makes them a lot of profit, but I'm not clear that this in fact does translate into a Protect New York Act. So I don't see a problem per se. Well, I guess I do, thinking out loud.
Senator Krueger, yes. could I assume that you're going to vote no on this bill? I mean,
no,
the record.
Struggling. I'm probably going to be asking questions on the floor.
I would understand that, but let the record note that you don't like the title also, because you did mention that. I want to make sure
Thank
you do that. Senator Hassel-Thompson and Senator Mazzoli.
Okay, I was hesitant before because I knew that prior to the question on MWD, I had another question. The
sure.
question that was there was, I guess it bothered me, is how is the legislation defining the nexus?
Defining the nexus? Senator Cannon said it was a legal term.
I understand it's a legal term, but not being a lawyer, that's why I'm asking.
I'm not a lawyer either, but Senator Breslin would like to answer that question for you.
I think it's weighing the measures of contact. I would view as a minimal nexus, and it would gradually go up depending upon its contacts with the state of New York.
All right, so giving them preference, then we're comfortable with them having a nexus that could be as minimal as having a post office address in one employee.
Which would be above just anyone who had no contacts.
But it's very minimal.
And Senator, I don't think that is the, it would
I'm
be that minimal.
I'm giving them preference
without
having a criteria which warrants that preference. That's all. I want to vote for them. I mean, I know a construction company who had one employee per se. But if he had done contracts with the state, they would have brought more jobs
sure.
or whatever to the city. That's not my issue.
Senator,
issue is
do you do that? Your point is well taken. I don't think the sponsor's intent here is to create a, quote, a situation in which someone could open a post office box or send an employee here, therefore making them eligible for consideration. I think that is not the intent here, but I understand your point.
And that I think is what leads to really what Senator Perkins' question was. That in order to get that preferential treatment, there are companies who would do that. You know that that's not the intent.
Oh, Senator, there are companies that would do a number of things.
And I would like to see the next the criteria be a little bit more
stringent. I believe the sponsor's intent here was to try to create an environment in which New York State employees come first and companies come first. Senator Nozzolio, did you have a comment?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, not to prolong the discussion, but I think maybe I can help shed some light on it. Senator Thompson, Senator Krueger, you have a lot of subway cars running around your district. A lot of those subway cars are built in the Southern Tier at one point. The reason why I'm suggesting this is because there is, for the MTA, a certain New York content bill requirement that the FDA have production in either state. Parenthetically, once they lose their contract, they end up, they have, the companies that have those contracts end up leaving. But I asked the opportunity to speak because it appears that this is a two-stage process. At first, you have to be the best bidder. That's first and foremost. But quality, cost, and efficiency are criteria. But adding an employee who's not involved in government relations is a criteria. And I think the best part of this legislation is the 20% rule. Mm-hmm. They said that the legislation requires that at least 20% of the gross revenue is is from a New York operation. It's better than we have now, which is absolutely no criteria, no ability to take a company, no discretion.
Senator DeGolio, I'm sorry, you're answering your question. Are you answering her question?
I thought so.
Okay, because if you could direct it through the chair, it would be.
Mr. Chairman, it appears that this. Lost my train of thought.
I'm sorry.
They're listening. That's even better. Thank you. It's you've got better than what we had before, which is absolutely not. And while New York State is producing its travel tourism brochures and out of state, whether the DPC is using out of state vendors for call centers, and the park system of the state is using those. I mean, now those are all examples of how you probably could have a New York company with a better nexus under Senator Breslin's definition in New York State. I think it's worth a try, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. The only thing and if I could just add to that, Senator Hanson Thompson will listen to the chair if he'd like to make a comment. Considered Mark Zuckerberg when he started Facebook, it would have been a post office box, a company of one person. I mean, that could also be an example. I mean, that would be certainly an extreme, but I mean, that could be an example of a company that is worth a few dollars today that started with one person.
No,
Senator Perkins, Senator Stewart Cousins actually had her hand up.
Yeah,
so I'd like to call on her first. Senator Stewart Cousins.
Okay. I think this is a good step. I think the first step, when you talk about Mark Zuckerberg, he had a presence not only in the state, but he was a former resident of the district I represent, Dallas County. And I think that's probably what is missing here, that it's not a fly by night. I show up, I have my post office box, so that there is some I think it would be a better bill if there was some criteria in terms of a time frame that you needed to be in the area to create the nexus in the same way that, you know, you can't, I mean, I think that's what's missing.
That's noted. Senator Perkins, did you want to add anything? Because I'd like to move the bill and then we can discuss some of these things on the floor.
No, I'm fine. I think the Senator.
Okay.
We
will move the bill. Could I have those negative votes, please? The hands for the negative votes.
I'm going to do that.
Okay, all right. I understand that, but I asked for the negative hands first.
My hands are negative. My vote is just not negative.
Here you go.
Mr. Senator Perkins, who is not negative, is voting no.
Senator
Parker, I'm sorry. If you're voting without recommendation, raise your hand.
Okay, thank you, Senator DeGolio.
If you're voting without recommendation, raise your hand. Cousins, Hassel Thompson, Kruger, and Perkins. Okay, thank you very much. And Senator Stewart Cousins, I'm sorry that Mr. Zuckerberg didn't give you a piece of the action.
I'm sorry, I didn't know him when, you know.
Senate 3667 by Senator Lane.
An act to amend the retirement and social security law in relation to the employment of police officers in the town of Southampton.
Where is that?
The bill is moved. 5108A by Senator Johnson.
An act to amend the civil practice law in rural required during the pendency of a stay of enforcement of a judgment against tobacco product master settlement agreement.
Any questions on this, Senator Senator Hassel Thompson?
Yes, ma'am.
I just asked
Senator Montgomery.
Explanation about the refuses to.
You asked me for that.
On your bill.
She asked for what's the bill? I didn't really expect them. I was just moving the bill for the
yes. That's why I'm
those who are voting without recommendation, raise your hand. Those who are voting no, please raise your hand. Perkins.
Hassel Thompson.
The other Perkins. Senator Krueger. In the negative, that's Senator Clark. Okay, moving right along here. Senator Leeson, 5587B.
An act to amend the tax law in relation to Program 635 Capital Companies.
Senator Krueger, is this a question or a no vote?
It's a question. Am I reading the bill correctly if I read that it's a 100% tax credit, so the dollar that is invested by the CAPCO is actually equal to the dollar lost to the state?
We are blessed to have our tax expert here, and he would be happy to answer that for you.
Thank you.
Yes, just like the first five CAFCO programs, it is a 100% credit. It's not given out the first year. It's only given out after a certain percentage of the investment funds have gone out. It's Senator Lacey's bill.
May I ask a follow-up question, Mr. Chair?
Senator Krueger, please continue with your follow-up question.
Thank you. So the advantage to the state of New York is we give up $150 million that we might choose to invest in specific companies or other activities in exchange for these insurance companies get to choose how they're investing the money rather than paying taxes.
No, the insurance companies is the capital.
Yeah.
The insurance companies invest in certified capital companies, venture capitals.
Yeah.
Those venture capitals have matching funds that they put in, and they in turn invest in emerging technology companies. That's how it works. I mean, the capital comes from the insurance company, but the actual investment comes from the certified capital.
Mr. Chair, I ask one more question.
Senator Krueger is going to ask you one more question.
So insurance companies invest their money on an ongoing basis. Now, the advantage to the state of New York with this program, we give up $150 million in taxes, but we are believing that this kind of investment activity will take place here in the state of New York with specific kinds of emerging companies. Is that accurate?
That's part of it. The other part is that those credits that we're giving out are actually leveraging private investment as well.
To put an estimated leverage formula there?
I believe it's 50%.
Thank you. Oh, yes, thank you.
Okay, any negative? Any without recommendation? The bill is moved. 5672A by Senator SBI.
An act to amend the executive law in relation to advertising in a language other than English by notaries public.
Without recommendation? No. Senator, what's your name? Senator Parker?
Move
Senator Marcellino voted without recommendation. You want to move the bill?
Yes.
Okay, bill is moved. Senator DeFrancisco, 5732.
An act to amend the tax law in relation to facilitating the compliance of grocery marketers with their obligation to collect sales tax.
Any negative votes? Senator LaValle?
I'm without.
Senator LaValle is without recommendation. Anybody else?
Some companies.
I'm sorry?
I'm
sorry.
Move
the
bill.
The bill is moved.
Excuse
yes, yeah, yes.
A groomery marketer is a company like Expedia or Orbitz or Hotels.com who simply markets hotel rooms when they are not the actual provider of the room.
Okay, thank you.
Senator O'Meara, 5753.
An act to amend the election law in relation to the conducting of the presidential primary.
Questions on this? The bill is moved. 5760 by Senator Bonassa.
An act to amend the tax law in relation to licenses issued by the Division of Water.
Any questions on the bill? Negative or recommendation? The bill is moved. 5778 by Senator Robach.
An act to provide for the adjustment of stipend of certain incumbents in the SUNY and designated monies, therefore.
Are there any negative votes or any without recommendation? The bill is moved. 5782 by Senator Leeson.
An act to amend the New York State Urban Development Corporation Act in relation to the capital access program.
Without recommendation, no votes. Move the bill. 5786 by Senator Young.
An act to amend the labor law in relation to permitted deductions from wages.
Any no votes without recommendation? The bill is moved. Senator Parker. Senator Parker, the other Senator Perkins is no. Senator Perkins is no. Senator Stewart Cousins is yes. And Senator Hassan Thompson is no. The bill is moved. All bills are reported to third reading. Meeting adjourned.